Now we're told then that the area A in square millimeters of a bacterial culture growing in milk, T hours after midday, is given by this equation here, where T is greater than or equal to zero. And in the first part of the question, then we've got to write down the area of the culture at midday. And that's going to be when T equals naught. When T equals naught, no wonder we can just write the answer down, because anything to the power naught is going to be 1. So A is going to equal 20. So therefore, A equals 20. 20 millimeter squares then. Now in part B, we've got to find the time at which the area of the culture is twice its area at midday. And we've got to give our answer to the nearest minute. So, if this is the area at midday, when it's twice its area, it's going to be when A equals 40. So, that's what we're going to do next, when A equals 40. Just substitute this into our equation up here. And so, you're going to have, therefore, 40 equals 20 e to the power 1.5 t. And if we divide both sides by 20, we're therefore going to have 2 equals e to the power 1.45, I should say, t. Now, when we've got an equation where the unknown is a power, what we tend to do is use logs. And because it's the base e, I'm going to use natural logs. I'm going to do the natural log of each side. Okay, so it's the natural log of 2 equals the natural log of e to the power 1.5t. And when you get something like this, what we can do is use the power rule for logs. That is, that when you've got a power like this, it can come out the front here. So therefore, you have the natural log of 2 equals 1.5t times the natural log of e. Now, the natural log of e, a log in its own base, is always 1. So what we've got then is the natural log of 2 equals 1.5t. A lot of you most probably knew that from here. If you took natural logs to both sides, you might well have written natural log of 2 equals simply 1.5t. So you could get down to that stage very quickly. So to get t, all I need to do now is get on a calculator and work out what the natural log of 2 divided by 1.5 is. And if you do that, you'll find that t turns out to be 0.462098 and so on. And remember, T is measured in hours, okay? So T is in hours. But we're asked to work out the time, giving our answer to the nearest minute. So if that's in hours, if we want it in minutes, okay, let's just put in minutes, T would equal that decimal 0.462098 and so on, multiplied by 60. Okay, and if you do that, what you end up with is 27.72 and so on, and that'll be minutes. So if we round that to the nearest minute, then we're looking at 28 minutes. Okay, to the nearest minute, let's just put that in there, to the nearest minute, min. Okay. So, I hope it's given you an idea then how to tackle that question.